Previously on the Ray Peacock podcast.
You can't use the word mental, Roger. No. Particularly when some of them are. What was it like being the character whose storyline really makes the bill what it is today?
But that's what happened. I had my brain sucked out by dying.
I sexually assaulted one of the cheeky girls. Roger, there's not a court in the land that would convict. So you started driving off with her child?
Yeah. I didn't mean to.
Roger, the fact that we said we'd keep this pedo light today, that didn't then give you carte blanche to go and abduct a child?
And number 12, well, that's just ridiculous. They've arrested people for that, there's nothing to do with
it. Benders.
Hey.
How's Benders going?
It's not called Benders.
No, they didn't train flea at all. When the flea circus was, there were no fleas on it. That's what a flea circus is. They didn't have a fucking box. They did Jesus Christ, man.
You didn't train fleas.
How would you go about training fleas?
It's not gay, this is it.
I don't think it's gay. I tell you what, this isn't gay.
Is it? Roger, get your cock out.
I got the shit beat out of me this week because of this fucking podcast, and you've not even got the common decency to go and fucking review a film you've agreed to review.
I just try and put up on you.
I should probably be in hospital.
Walking behind me, pointing at me, and asking people as they pass by, "Do you remember him?" Over the tannoy, in a rather busy town centre. Tesco's
very, very busy. Outside.
Would little Raji James, who used to be on EastEnders, please report to customer services as his daddy is waiting for him.
Well, basically you're waiting on some news.
Yeah.
Potentially life-changing news.
Oh, yes.
Potentially life-threatening news.
So, in some respects.
So, yeah, so basically that we will probably reveal that next week.
Yeah.
Depending which way the coin falls. And it's episode 10.
Episode 10?
Final episode in series 1.
Yeah.
So, would it count as the final episode?
Well, it is the final. What do you mean? Of course.
Well, we're only having like a month off, isn't it?
You mean, does it count as a season?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Roger says so, then it is. That's little Roger James over there. Hello, little Roger James. You used to be on EastEnders but ruined it.
Hello.
How are you this week?
Tired.
Any more sex?
No, not this week.
Brilliant. Thank God for that.
Yeah.
I'm very, very tired as well.
Are you?
In a way, I'm probably more tired than you.
Don't be silly. You can't be more tired than me. I've been up all night. I haven't slept.
Normally one of us is tired, but today both of us are tired.
Yeah, but I haven't slept, so I'm more tired.
How much sleep have you had?
None.
Shut up.
Literally none.
I've had 2 hours.
I've had none since 7 o'clock yesterday morning.
Brilliant. Okay, yeah, Benders last night.
Yeah.
Or Benders. Did it work this week?
Did you see what I did there? I can't even be asked fighting about what it's called.
Yeah, I said Benders, you went, yeah.
Yeah.
Are you really that tired?
Yes.
Or can you sort of jolt yourself up a
little? I'm gonna.
Because I'm tired as well.
Right.
This would be a great time for us to have cocaine, wouldn't it?
I wouldn't know.
Have you ever done cocaine though?
Long, long, long time ago.
You don't do it now?
No.
I don't do any drugs at all, I'm completely clean.
Yeah.
Cocaine would be good today.
I'm not sure it would.
Well, no, it would help. It would gee us up a little bit.
I don't think...
Go out and get some cocaine.
No.
Roger, get some cocaine!
Dude.
I can't believe for the final episode you're not going to get some cocaine! How selfish and self-centred are you?
Do the intro.
This is the intro, I want you to go and get some cocaine.
I'm getting your cocaine.
Get us some coke, Roger!
No.
Go and get some ching.
Ching?
Go get some Charlie.
What?
Let's have some cocaine on the last episode. How exciting would that be to have some cocaine?
I think it'd be horrible. My memory of what it was like having cocaine is horrible.
Yeah. Well, you see, the thing is, I think if we had cocaine, there's always a risk that I become objectionable.
As opposed to...
If I had cocaine, then I might start coming across as a bit of a wanker. And I wouldn't want to come across as arrogant. I wouldn't like that.
I refer the right honourable gentleman to my previous answer.
I wouldn't like to, you know, sort of... I'd probably start shouting, you know, talking down to you, being quite aggressive, passive-aggressive. I'd probably start taking the piss out of you all the time if I had cocaine, so... Probably best that we don't have cocaine. But I am, at the moment, I'll tell you what, though, quite genuinely...
What?
I'm feeling quite on the edge.
Of?
Just on the edge, generally.
Right.
I feel like I could go through a cocaine phase at the moment.
Really?
Yeah. Because I think I might be close to death.
What are you talking about
now? I've got a genuine feeling about it. Do you know what?
What?
I think I might have been meant, in the grand scheme of things,
right?
I think I might have been meant to have been killed when I got beat up around the corner from here. Remember the bit when I got
Yeah, yeah.
I think I was meant to die in that.
And you
because ever
on.
Since then, I've had like near death experiences. Ever since then, have you ever seen Final Destination?
Yes.
I think it's like that.
Right.
I think death is chasing me.
Right.
Because and also the ways that it's happening are getting more like in when I was at the garage of the week and that bloke started getting electrocuted. I think that was meant for me.
Right.
I think I was meant to be electrocuted in my car.
Right.
But the bloke fitting the radio thing, it happened to him.
Do you know what?
What?
I think you are more tired than me.
No, listen, right?
Because you're getting delirious.
No, I'm not, because because when I did, you know, the Big Chill on Sunday?
Yeah.
Big Chill Festival. Went and did a reading, an author's reading. It wasn't a gig. I did an author's reading.
Yeah.
Of some of my written work.
Yeah.
My blog, I read that out. It went down very well.
Good.
They blinked at me, so that was a good sign. That's good. At the Big Chill, that's a brilliant sign.
Instead of applauding.
No, the Big Chill, to get them to even blink,
right.
Is a fucking... that's the equivalent of like a 10-minute standing ovation.
Is that because they're all stoned?
Off the fucking head, mate. In a fucking world of their own. And it was the hottest day of the year as well, and I'm stood there reading, and I started getting double vision. But anyway, when I'm driving back through all the windy roads and all that sort of stuff in Herefordshire,
yeah.
I don't know how far I got, because I was going to do a gig in Banbury.
That's right.
Straight after it. Listen to this. I undertook it, actually. I shouldn't have undertook it, but I did.
Right.
There was a trailer carrying a caravan
yeah.
in the right-hand lane on a dual carriageway, right?
Right, yeah.
Going really quite slow.
Okay.
So I had to undertake it. It should have been in the other side, really, but I had no choice. I had to get past it. As I was getting past it, I had the roof down as well. I could see the caravan moving and stuff, and I was just sort of laughing to myself, thinking, fuck you. God, imagine if that falls off and kills me. And it came over too far.
Right.
And I was like, this fucker's coming off. And I put my foot down. If it had been in my old car, I'd have been dead. Because my old car had no pickup in it at all.
Right.
But the car I've got now, once I'm in sort of fifth gear, it's got quite good accelerating. I put my foot down fast. And I put my foot down. You couldn't have even... if it was a stunt, you couldn't have done it better. As I passed it, the caravan came off and smashed onto the ground.
Get out of here.
Smashed onto the fucking
ground. Get out of
here. It was the equivalent of Indiana Jones pulling his hat underneath the door. It was unbelievable. Death is fucking after me, sir.
Fuck!
Death's after me.
I've just swore because I'm genuinely...
Now, do you believe me? I think I was meant to die in that beating up.
That's weird.
Death's coming after me.
Well, I'll tell you what, if that's the case, you know what we should do? Just in case.
Just kill me.
No.
And then we beat death. No, then we beat death. I'll commit suicide at the end of this podcast.
No.
Right, one ratings.
No, listen.
Two publicity.
No, listen.
Three, I beat death.
Stop talking.
Beating death's most important to me.
All right.
Come on, death.
You can if you like,
this is what happens when you survive a suicide attempt.
Do you know
death comes after you.
Before you do die,
yeah.
Let's round everything up, just in case this is actually the final episode. Because you've got lots of bits and pieces of stories that we've had over the past 10
I can't help but feel you're prioritising the wrong things.
Why?
Not go and put my house in order.
Well,
not
this
go
is...
and say goodbye to all my friends.
Well, this is starting that, isn't it?
Not make sure that all my bastard children are all going to be okay.
Well, we can cover that later. But let's put all the little bits and pieces of stories in order, because I think there's a lot of listeners out there that are kind of waiting to hear the end of various, you know...
Sorry, can I just quote you back?
What?
I think there's a lot of listeners out there.
Alright, I think there's a listener.
I think you're fucking really overreaching yourself with that.
I think there's a listener out there.
Alright, well, can't I just ring your mum and tell her? Alright, well, let's tie everything up today. Thank you for joining us, by the way. Is everything alright, Raji? Other than you being tired? Is everything alright in your life?
Well, you know there's... Well, you know there was some news I was waiting for. So.
Well, we're going to announce that or something.
Right, okay.
But is everything other than that? I mean, I know it's very stressful, but I've noticed stuff coming here today. How thin you look.
What?
I mean, I know I do as well, but I mean, you look like really skinny.
I
just look slim, but you're sort of like...
No, I keep a very consistent weight. Oh, I have done since I was about 25.
What, you've had 7.5 stone, something like that?
No, 9.5.
You're under 10 stone?
Yeah.
You're an adult man?
Yeah, I've always been between 9.5 and 10 stone.
Right.
At my heaviest, I was just over 10 stone. That was when I was doing yeast disease.
This is the reason you're never invited on Parkinson.
Why?
This is because your stories are rubbish.
What?
You'll pass that off as an anecdote.
What?
Do you know what? I've always been between 9.5 and 10.5.
You asking me factual questions?
Ever since I was on East is East. Yes, that's right. I was in a film one time. Do you remember me from EastEnders? Do you remember me? Do you remember me? That'd be you on Parkinson.
I'm not going to do Parkinson.
It'd be pointing at Laurie Holloway before you even knew what had happened.
Who's Laurie Holloway?
Fucking Phil, they'd have said, the bandmaster bloke. Phil! Fill it now! Just play anything! It had to be you, play that, anything! The other thing as well, I went into your kitchen before.
Yes.
Now, your bottle of whiskey
Yes.
Has depleted dramatically since I was last here.
Do I like whiskey?
Well, quite clearly you like whiskey. You drink it like fucking pop. You can't... A bottle of whiskey should last you a year.
Don't be stupid. A bottle of whiskey, you're lucky if it lasts a fortnight.
You're lucky if it lasts a day around here.
It's been a week since you were here.
You're an alcoholic.
Not finished.
You're an alcoholic.
So?
Brilliant. If any more people have that attitude...
So?
We're going to be great at an AA meeting. I'm an alcoholic. So am I. We all are. Fucking hell, what's up with you? Stop showing off. It's not exactly hard, is it?
And your point is?
Okay. Well, the other thing I'm worried about as well is there were lots of letters from the Inland Revenue on your side.
I know, haven't dealt with them.
You've not even opened them?
No.
That's alarming.
No, those ones haven't opened with the VAT.
Okay. Why haven't you opened them?
Because I've already sent them a letter to say about moving house and they're still sending letters to my brothers.
Oh, I see. They come from your other address.
Yeah, I've just picked them up yesterday from my brothers.
Because you live with your brother.
Yeah.
When she threw you out.
When I left.
When she took the kids.
When I left.
Even though legally now you're allowed to have them after we had that court case.
After
week.
Judge Connolly sorted it out.
Judge Connolly sorted it right out last week. God bless Judge Connolly.
He's a good man.
He is a good man indeed.
Do you know, for days after that, I was trying to do Billy Connolly impersonations.
Oh, go on, do one then.
No, it was really bad.
Oh, let's hear you try one.
I was in the bath trying to do it. It was really terrible.
Brilliant. I love your life. I think that's amazing. The image of you just sat with your little todger out and just in the bath, start bullet naked. Can't even afford matey bubble bath. You had to sit in just normal water with all your grime just coming off it and rising to the surface.
Oh,
and you sat there just trying to do Billy Connolly impressions. Roger, what the fuck has happened to your life? Did you not sit there going, what have I done?
No, I was having a really nice, I was actually having a nice relaxing Radox bubble bath.
Did you have candles on?
And I just, no, I didn't.
Look at you with your brand names.
Radox. I'll get some.
Not saying to
be. Do you know, we still haven't got any free gifts from anyone.
I have.
You've got your helicopter.
I've had stuff since as well. Have I not even told you?
No.
Oh, I'll tell you later on. So go on.
So, yeah, and I just found myself trying to do Billy Connolly.
In the bath, and what did you do? Let's hear it.
I was just doing sort of like you would, you know, like when you do it, you do it. Isn't it amazing, isn't it? But I can't get it that deep.
Fucking my impression's pretty bad, but that one
was
appalling.
No, yours is good.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do it.
Okay.
I've done that now.
Alright.
I'm not gonna do it again. I don't know. I'm actually now physically trying to stop myself doing an impression of Billy Connolly.
I can see it in your eyes, actually.
I actually don't really
want to
do it.
You're on the edge of doing it.
I'm not gonna do it.
But you're not gonna do it.
Jobby!
That's what you wanna say.
Jobby, brilliant. So the other thing.
Yes.
Was the thing that we flagged up last week.
We did, and I knew you were going to bring it up, so...
Well, obviously,
we
flagged it up last week, so we can stop on it.
I had some news. Well, I had some almost news.
Let's get out of the way. I think most people have guessed, but let's get out of the way what the problem was.
A girl that I'd slept with several...
Look at that. See how he says that? A girl. Not the girl.
Several weeks ago.
A girl that he had sexual intercourse with.
Quite some time ago. Phoned me and said that... Her period hadn't come,
right.
And that she was a little bit
period.
Late.
Don't say period, that sounds horrible.
What did I say?
Just say that she hasn't come on the blob yet.
Oh, God.
Don't say period, that sounds terrible.
Okay.
So go on, so she's late.
So she was late, so...
Now, was this contraceptive failure?
Well, failure to use, yeah.
Brilliant, well done. How old are you?
I know, 37.
How old are you, okay. If your child came to you,
yes.
Your eldest came to you and said
yes.
That he might have got a girl in trouble, and you said... Or did you use any contraception? You went, no. What would you say?
Well, I would have said, well, that's stupid, but what are we going to do about it? Kind of situation.
You'd have got the knitting needles out and said,
come on,
I'll sort this.
No.
That is idiotic, sir.
I know it's idiotic.
And the thing is as well, you told me that you did it a few times that night, and you went as if this was all right, but one time we didn't use protection.
Yeah.
That's stupid on two levels. One, you should use protection. And two, that's wasted all the other fucks. All the times that you use protection, you needn't have even bothered.
Yeah, I know.
So you may as well have just had it properly all those times.
Well, yeah.
So go on.
It was very stupid.
So last week we were waiting.
Juvenile mistake.
Last week we were waiting to hear.
Well, I was waiting to hear, and then after...
We didn't know if she was or not.
No, and after last week she did a test, and...
What test?
A pregnancy test.
Right, okay.
Not a Mensa test.
Brilliant. I did a Mensa test recently.
What?
155 I got.
How did you get...
I've got an IQ of 155, thank you very much.
Sorry, how did you do... Was this in a newspaper or something? And you marked it yourself?
No, it was on the internet.
So it's regulated?
Yeah, it's a proper Mensa test.
Right.
155 IQ. Brilliant. I'm a genius.
Hold on, how can you be...
That makes me... And do you know what makes me even more of a genius?
What?
Some of them questions, I just guessed them. Just guessed.
What do you mean you
in
just
guessed? I think maybe the last 5 or 10 questions on it.
5 or 10?
Because I was running out of time. I just put B's for all of them. Just put B for... I didn't even read the questions, just put B.
So...
And I've still got 155.
You know that doesn't count, right?
I'm a genius.
No, that doesn't
count. I'm a genius without even trying.
That doesn't count.
Anyway, we're getting distracted. I am a genius, then.
Right.
Just so we know that.
And I'm stupid, so great.
What's your IQ?
Well, last time I had it tested, it was about 142.
One.
142.
One's quite good. One's good, though, for someone like you. Anyway, we're all worried that you might have fathered another child.
Yes.
You've got two already that are suffering.
They're not suffering.
Having you as a father.
They're off having...
There might now be another one that you have to abandon.
Well...
You're not happy abandoning two children. You've got to abandon three now.
Actually, my boys are going to be with me for the next 3 weeks.
My boys.
My boys.
Oh, you sound like Mike Reed when you say that. It makes me sad.
Oh.
Go on.
Anyway, pregnancy test was negative. So we kind of had a big chat, and that was kind of all right.
Was it a doctor one?
No.
Chemist one.
Yeah.
And then, you know, that's not 100%.
I know. Well, this is the thing. Then yesterday.
Well, let me say as a public service announcement, because I know about these things. A pregnancy test that you buy over the counter.
Yeah.
Can say you're not if you are.
Yeah.
But it can't say you are if you're not.
Yeah, I kind of get that.
So hers said she's not.
Yeah.
Which means there's a slim chance, though, that she still is.
Well, this is the thing, because I got a message yesterday.
Brilliant.
And she said that not to burst
the bubble. Is this how we want to announce your impending fatherhood?
I don't know.
On a podcast?
I don't know. I don't even know why I'm talking about it. It's only because I'm tired and my defences are down.
Okay, great.
And
what's the name of your club night? What's the name of your club night?
Ramp.
Just say it. Just do it for me. What's the name of your club night?
Benders.
That's right, Raji. Your name of your club night is Benders.
Right.
Go on.
Oh, God. Oh, I'm genuinely sad. Anyway...
Cocaine. Let's get some cocaine.
No, we're not getting cocaine.
Okay.
stop it. Oh, God.
I reckon the boys that beat me up might have some cocaine. I can go and walk down that street again and just see if they're knocking
just
about.
Just see if they're finding.
And say, lads, come on, get off. Don't hit me again. I'm going to buy some Charlie off you.
Buy what? Charlie?
Charlie cocaine.
Why is it called Charlie?
I don't know.
Where would that come from?
I don't care what it's called. I'm too busy taking it.
Is that the song Cocaine Charlie?
I don't know.
That champagne, Charlie.
I'm too busy taking it all the time. Snort it right on my nose.
That could be
like what all the great people do.
That could be an end of season competition.
What?
If people can write in to tell us why it's called Charlie,
then they win some.
Then you'll buy them.
That'll
some.
That'll get us on the front page of all the papers, won't it?
Yeah, then you'll buy.
Yeah, there
them
you
some.
Go. If anybody can write in, write to the MySpace account. If you can write in and tell us why cocaine is known as Charlie, we will send you some cocaine. There you go. Controversial.
But
it's legally binding.
So
is she pregnant or not?
Well, she said, because she has a child already from a previous relationship.
Right, so she should have learned as well.
And she said that, just to let me know, that when she was with her previous partner, and she thought she was pregnant before she took a pregnancy test and it came out negative.
And she was pregnant.
And she was pregnant.
Right.
And still now, another week on, she still hasn't, her period still hasn't.
Okay.
So, it's sort of, that's some news, isn't it?
Well, it's some news insofar that it's none. So, we're going to round things up.
What's left?
Before we start the exciting new series in a few weeks' time.
Yeah, and it is going to be exciting.
Ed will be back. That'll upset a lot of people.
He's not going to come back and record, though, is he?
It'd be a shame.
We were only doing that to get him sort of promo for his Edinburgh show.
No, Ed's coming in.
Oh.
Ed's official. Ed's staying. Look, anybody that takes my side in bullying you is welcome to be in this podcast.
That's not fair. So,
by the end of this, by the end of the 100 episodes that we've committed to doing, by the end of this...
Sorry, what?
I want there to be about 50 people... on this podcast, all of them just shouting at you.
So can I bring friends on my side?
If you can find any, yeah, by all means.
We'll do an episode where I'll have some of my girls.
Yeah, right, okay.
Yeah.
In increasing stages of labour. It'll be like that thing of Neanderthal man going into fucking tip down my
head.
It'll just be fucking all different sizes bellies. That's what'll happen. By all means, we'll do that.
Let's
as a podcast,
do that.
Yeah.
Right.
By all means.
That'd be hilarious.
I love shouting at you.
I know you do.
I love it. And I hardly even do it on the podcast. This is the thing, because people say to me, are you really like that with him in real life? It's like, I am far worse.
Yeah, you are. Normally.
I properly shout at you.
Yeah.
Like, but raise my voice really loud as well.
Well, in the early days of the podcast, I was getting quite a lot of messages on MySpace from people saying, why did you put up with it? Why?
Yeah.
You know, he's really nasty. And yeah. I don't think people got your natural charm. I don't think it came across early.
They didn't realise that you were in love with me.
Yeah, possibly. Yeah.
Well, I shouted at you today as well. You went to the passport office today.
I did, and you were shouting at me down the phone while
really,
I was in the queue.
Really loud.
It's not funny asking me to say, what was it you were saying? Which
one
of the
favorite?
People in front or behind you, which is your favourite? And you've got to tell the one that's your favourite that they're your favourite. And you've got to tell the one that you don't like that you don't like them. Tell them now! Tell them now!
And you've got to tell them why as well.
Yeah.
And you have to choose now, Raj. You have to choose now. Me and Ed started doing that, didn't we, when we were driving
to
cars. We just started screaming at you, asking you what your favourite things were.
But it's, do you know, the thing about today, though, in the passport office, right? Because I've had a hell of a day with this passport business. Yeah. Like a hell of a couple of days with it, actually.
Can I just say it was embarrassing for me as well today, when I was shouting down the phone?
Yeah.
Could you say, no, it was embarrassing for you, because it was really loud down the phone?
Yeah.
When I was doing that shouting, I was sat in traffic, and there was a bloke selling the Evening Standard in the middle of the road. And he thought I was shouting him over for an Evening Standard.
Oh, no.
Where I was actually, I had my hands free on, so, and it, I was underneath my hair. He just thought I was just a bloke in a car just shouting.
So you were just a mad person in a car.
So it was you know, it was difficult for me as well.
Well, then why were you doing it?
Because I wanted to know who your favourite person was, Raji! I need to know who your favourite is, like the person behind you and the person in front of you. You need to choose which one's your favourite, and you can't choose the person behind you. And the person that's in front of you, you need to tell them that they're your favourite. And the person behind you, you have to tell them that they're your least favourite, and you have to tell them why. And it's true and forever, and you can't change it afterwards.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And the thing was, while you were shouting, was the moment I got to the front of the queue.
Brilliant.
And the security guard is saying to me, because it's really top security there, and he says, oh, you've got to take your jacket off, sir, and you've got to do that. And I'm going, yeah, sorry, in a minute. And you're still going on.
Someone like you,
well,
who we've already established, is the British Bin Laden.
Yeah, thank you for that.
We already know that you're trouble.
Added on top of that,
yeah,
that the people behind me had heard some of my responses to you on the phone, and at the same time, when I'd looked around embarrassingly, kind of smiling in that kind of, oh, I'm sorry, he's so loud way, the woman goes, EastEnders!
Brilliant.
So I've got woman behind me going EastEnders, I've got security guard in front of me going, come on sir, you're holding the queue up, get your mobile phone, blah blah, and then I'll get you shouting at me down the phone and not stopping even when I told you that I was at the front
and
of the queue.
And you have the audacity and the nerve to complain about your life.
What are you talking about?
Life, how exciting is your life?
That's not exciting, that's annoying.
You had your great mate shouting and joking me on the phone, you had security guards taking you seriously, you had a fucking deluded woman recognising you off the telly. That's brilliant, what a day.
All in the same 5 minutes.
If only you could find some money, you'd have a brilliant life.
Well, that's true.
So the loose ends of this series.
Oh, of course, that's what we were doing. Loads of points.
Now, the first one that occurred to me the other day, we never said about your casting. When you shaved your arms.
Yeah.
And you went for casting.
Yeah.
I presume you didn't get the job.
Well, I presumed that as well, but now that all my hair's grown back, and it's now been, what, full?
It's not grown back properly.
Well, no, but it doesn't, apparently, with that cream.
It still looks like a lady's frou-frou. A lady who shaved it all off and it started growing back. It still looks that way.
I might have to shave it all off again.
Why?
Because they found...
Have you got the part?
No, they phoned up and they still haven't cast the part.
What?
They still haven't cast it. So
but this was for quite a major series.
Yeah, quite a major series and the main part in the major series.
Yeah.
So they still haven't cast it.
They have.
No, they haven't. They've got a phone call today.
No.
Yes.
No.
I'm going to see them on Monday.
Okay, I believe you.
Yeah.
But well, then you've probably got the part then.
Well, I don't know.
I reckon you have.
I genuinely don't know.
Because no.
Well, what they said, and I want to say this because it's a nice compliment, but the director has asked the message to be passed on.
You're not bad for a Ferrara.
Almost.
Right. Okay.
That having reviewed all the tapes of all the people that auditioned, I was
the best of a bad lot.
He said I was the only one that got the scope and the scale of what was required.
Right.
That's quite nice.
I reckon they've already started filming. You were meant to have been filming that ages ago. I reckon they've already started filming. I reckon they've started filming with someone else.
And they've gone, well...
And it's not worked. And now they're going to the second
worst.
They
can't have done that in a major
They're now going to the second worst one.
Thanks.
But of course they can do that. They can do that with a major show.
Wow.
Of course you can. That happens all the time.
Yeah, but not something like this because it'll be on a time schedule.
Don't be so stupid. Fucking, what was the bloke out of, Tremphon Mask? The one we share? Eric Stoltz.
Yeah.
You know, the big lion face, man.
Vaguely.
Lion man.
Yeah, I can't remember it.
He was all deformed and his mum was Cher. Fucking imagine that.
Right.
Being deformed and your mum was Cher.
That's got to be a bad
You
life.
Would do away with yourself. And yeah. I believe he did it at the end of the film. I don't want to ruin it for anyone.
Right.
Yeah, the film, Eric Stoltz.
I know him.
Well, he was in Pulp Fiction. He was the drug dealer in Pulp Fiction as well.
Drug dealer.
He was one that was on the phone going, I can't believe you're calling me on a cell phone.
Right? Oh, yeah.
Like
yeah,
that,
yeah,
geezer,
yeah, yeah.
Right?
Okay, yeah, got you.
He's a really good actor.
Yeah, he is. Yes.
He was a really...
He's been in loads.
Well, sure, why I tell him a story.
Okay.
He was going to play Marty McFly in Back to the Future.
What?
And he filmed loads of it. He filmed loads and then they sacked him or something happened in it.
And
they got Michael. It is totally true.
No, come on, the film of that would be released somewhere. They'd have footage.
There's still images of it. You can get still images of it.
Yeah.
On the DVD released Back to the Future, you see some still images of it, but there's no film of it.
Oh, someone's got that. Someone, you know what they're like, these production things, that someone will have thought of themselves, oh, in the future that would be worth money. Do you know... What?
Maybe they got in the DeLorean, went forward and checked, and it wasn't, so they didn't bother. You're in a film with a Bollywood star.
Aishwarya Rai.
No, Sophia Hyatt.
Sophia Hyatt?
Yeah.
Yes.
When we were talking about her, because I was saying the other night, and you said you didn't want me to say this, but I'm going to say it anyway.
Go on.
She does look like a transvestite, eh?
She does have some masculine...
She looks like a man.
In some pictures, she has some masculine facial features.
And you're in a film where you're all sexing with her and all that.
Yeah.
What's that film called again?
The Unforgettable.
Isn't it weird that I keep forgetting that?
But that's what, there yeah. you go.
Because there's a website up right now, isn't
there? There is.
What's it called?
I can't remember. The Unforgettable Movie.com.
Whatever it is, no one's going to watch it. So
actually, it's quite funny, because I think the title actually is The Unforgettable The Movie.
Right.
.com.
Brilliant.
Which is clever, isn't
it? But it is an Indian film anyway.
Well, it's made by an Indian production company, but it's in English.
But we've discussed it on the podcast before, because on the trailer you're sexing up with her and she's got her busted out and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
But she's a bit... I'm not one for judging people on appearance and that. Yeah. She doesn't look like a man.
She doesn't in real life, but in some pictures...
It is like Rocky Horror or something.
It's not.
No, it is, so that's what she looks like.
No, she
I think she looks like Frankenfurter.
No, she's very pretty in real life.
She's really not.
In real life she is.
Not to me.
And in the film she is. But it's just in some still shots. I don't know what it is, whether it's lighting or what. Horsey?
It's just my opinion, I think she looks horsey.
No.
Horsey mammy.
No.
She looks like a masculine horse.
So she's got an incredible body.
So?
Really toned.
But anyway, you were talking about her as if she was this big thing. And you were
no,
saying...
No, I was saying
you said,
she's...
oh, she's well connected, which I argued. I said, well, she's well
no,
connected.
No, she is.
What the fuck should you do in a film with you?
Yeah, that was...
If she's well connected, she'd be in a proper film, not just a fucking straight to DVD. But even, I bet it's not even straight to DVD. I reckon The Unforgettable will be straight to video.
Do
I reckon that's what's going to happen. I reckon that film's going to go straight to video.
Do they do video now?
I think they're going to start doing video. It's going to go straight to Betamax. Just to guarantee that no fucker ever sees it.
Go straight to YouTube.
So you were saying now, and you said she was always in newspapers and stuff. And
she's got quite a high press profile.
China white people.
Yeah, she's got quite a high press profile.
But she was on that Bollywood Dreams thing, wasn't she? She was on that fucking...
Yeah, no, I didn't know that.
That reality show.
Yeah, I didn't know that when I was working with her. But the people in the sort of Bollywood scene when we were out there filming, they knew her from that.
Yeah.
So it's kind of weird what...
Honestly, I'm not panicking about upsetting her.
No, but I don't think it's just that. It's just the fact that, you know, people don't deserve to be...
I've taken against her.
Yeah, but you've taken against her for no real reason.
Yeah, no.
So that's why it's not fair.
I'll
turn
to say that. I've got nothing to back this up with.
Yeah, but that's why it's
at
not
all.
Fair.
And I just get the feeling that she's not a very nice person. And I've got nothing to base that on.
Well, she's fine.
Did you get on with her on set?
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, it was a really...
Was she prima donna-ish?
I think we both had moments where we were, because it was a really, really tough schedule. I mean, we were filming for like 16 hours a day, and we did 30 odd days straight. And even though Sophia wasn't in every scene, when she was in scenes...
Sophia, I'm going to call her.
What?
Sophia.
What difference is that?
What's her second name?
Hyatt.
I'm going to pronounce that titwank. That's how I pronounce it, Roger. You can't criticise me for it. That's just the way that I pronounce it. Sophia Titwank, that's what I call her.
That's your accent, is
that's,
it?
That's how I pronounce that word.
That's not very nice.
What? Why not? It's how I pronounce it.
Why do you say not nice things about people I know or people that I...
Because I don't like you having other friends.
Is that what it is? It's your jealousy?
Don't like it at all. I don't like the Eds and Edinburgh with other friends. I don't like it.
Oh, so it's not just me. It's basically anyone.
It's you and Ed.
Just me and Ed.
I think it's unfair on me.
Do you not
me.
Think this is something you
I think
need
it's unfair on me, Raju.
Do you not think it's something you need to work on?
Why?
Well, you might find that
there's... I don't like that you go out. I don't like that you go to Benders.
Well, I don't just go to Benders. I sort of run it.
I don't care. I don't like it.
It's a...
I don't like that you do Benders when I'm not there. I don't like that.
Well, then come down.
I don't like that you socialise with other people.
That's not a social...
I don't like the... Well, no, I'm not talking about Benders. I mean, generally.
Oh, right.
I don't like the other people that you socialise with.
Right. At all.
I don't like any of them.
What about people I work with?
Well, if you get a job, then I'll worry about that.
But for the time being, I don't need to worry about that
because you don't work with anybody at the moment.
But you're saying it about Sophia.
I don't need to worry about it now. I don't like the people that you socialise with this week.
This week?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like your children. I don't like your children. Who's best, me or your children?
My children.
Roger, I can't believe you just said that when I'm supposed to be your friend.
Yeah, you're my friend, you're not my son.
I hate that. How do you know I'm not your son?
I'd have had to have been 4 when you were conceived.
I might be lying about my age.
What, so you're 23? I don't think you are.
Isn't it weird how the number 23 keeps cropping up everywhere? What's the stupidest thing you've ever done to impress a girl?
I can't think of anything.
I've got two.
What?
If that's, I'm going to go as far as 3.
Go on.
I've sustained really bad injuries on 3 occasions.
Yeah.
Trying to impress girls.
What do you mean?
Years ago when I was a teenager.
Why?
One was when I was at school.
Yeah.
And I was trying to impress this girl called Ashley.
Yeah.
Who I'm still friends with now. And I went out with her for a bit. but we're friends now. And I was jumping about on the school field at the lower school, Salvin Jones. And I was doing like cartwheely things and stunts.
Right.
And stuff, just showing off. And I put my hand in a broken bottle. And I've got a really big scar on my hand from it. See there?
Ow!
There's my scar from that. That's one.
Right.
The other thing was, I used to work at a butcher's shop.
Right.
I worked in my granddad's butcher's shop.
The idea of using your sharp knives worries me.
Well, listen, I went to my... I can do all butchery stuff. I'm really good at it. I went to my granddad's butcher's shop, which was in Parr in St. Helens. But then when his shop shut down, I went and worked in another one called Highcox Butchers, which is also in Parr in St. Helens. It's since shut down. But they had a bacon slicer.
Right.
My granddad's shop never had a bacon slicer. He did it all by hand. But in Highcox, they had a bacon slicer. And there was a girl walked in, and I was being like all flirty with her and stuff. And went to cut bacon. We didn't even have a safety guard on, which was really bad. But I went to cut the bacon. Right. Hadn't put the bacon in the bacon slicer.
Right.
Put my thumb straight through it. So that's that scar there.
Ow!
That was impressing a girl. Second after I did it, I went all faint. Health and safety walked in.
With blood everywhere?
No, I wrapped my hand up in it in like a rag thing. And made out I was cleaning. While all the time the health and safety were in there.
And you're one.
And when they left, I fainted. And the other thing I did, which was to impress a girl, which was a girl I was already going out with.
Right.
A girl called Nikki, who I was going out with the first year I was at college, at university. Yeah. And I was reminded of this the other day, because somebody that I was at university with had just added me on Facebook, and he was reminding me about it. I'm big on playing with fire. Not so much anymore, but I used to be.
Yeah.
Lighter fluid, love.
Yeah.
Love it.
I went through a phase of that.
On a lino floor.
On a lino floor?
You know, like a... You know, like,
get a pool of it and turn it alight.
Fucking, I used to do a circle around me.
Right.
Set fire to it and set myself on fire.
Yeah.
And it just burns out really, really
quickly. Yeah, I used to do it with my hand.
Yeah, so you put out your arm and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very, still very dangerous.
Yeah.
I'm not advising anybody to do it.
No.
I used to do it a lot. But I did this thing where I'd been playing with lighter fluid all day. I'd had it on the work surfaces and stuff.
Yeah.
I made like little tracks with it on the breakfast bar thing that we had in my house all day. And I was looking for better things to do. And I put it, I don't know why I thought this in my fucking head, I put it in an empty wine bottle. I sort of half filled with lighter fluid. And I thought, I'll just light the top of this.
What?
And like all orange flames will come out. But of course, that's a fucking Molotov cocktail.
Yeah.
That didn't occur to me at all at the time. I honestly thought, it'd be like an oil refinery just burning off.
Just off the top?
Yeah. So I did all that, lit me match, put my hand over the bottle.
Why?
Because I was going to drop the match into the bottle so the flames come out. Obviously the match never got to the fucking bottle. Just fucking went off. Like, really bad burns on my hand.
Oh my God.
Really bad burns on my hand. And I'm surprised they've healed. They've healed perfectly. That's probably the most ridiculous thing I've ever done to impress a girl.
You're an idiot.
And a girl I was already going out with.
I tell you, it's not so much the most impressive thing I've ever done,
right?
But a really stupid thing I've ever done.
Well, that was the original question.
No, but you said, what's to impress? This wasn't really to impress.
Right, so what's the stupidest thing
you've
ever done?
Yeah, no, I've done a stupid thing with a girl, but it wasn't to impress.
All these words are irrelevant.
It was to be desperate.
Okay. What did you do? Well, fly to Dublin?
Yeah. No.
Is that the stupidest thing you've ever done?
No, that was a very
opened
good...
a club night in Soho.
No. They're both very good things.
Are they all within the last few weeks?
No.
When registered on a dating site.
No.
See, go on.
The fact that those aren't the most ridiculous thing I've ever done.
I'm looking forward to what they are, though.
Well, it's kind of pathetic, really, rather than in any way amusing.
Well, whatever way would it be with you?
Yeah, I guess. I'm not even fighting, am I? I'm not fighting any of your comments.
No, if you do. We've got to episode 10, your resolve has gone completely.
It's just died.
This is purely me bullying you now. And it's worse than normal because I am just bullying someone that doesn't even need to be bullied. They're already a broken man. And yet this is the equivalent of kicking fuck out of a corpse. That's, in a way, it's completely pointless. There's no point in this at all. I'm kicking fuck out of a dead body. I'm expending energy that I need to
do. I really shouldn't be finding any of this funny. I should be in some way insulted.
Let's
put
get
out.
Some cocaine.
No, not cocaine.
Right. Let's get some cocaine and right. Really bad.
Many years ago, there was a young girl who I was madly in love with.
Well, it would be a young girl, were you? What, she 4, 5?
No, stop it. She was the same age as me.
Can you be in love with a child?
She was a year older than me at the time, actually.
Okay. How old were you?
I was about 20. 20.
20,
okay. 20, yeah. And anyway.
20 years old.
We'd kind of.
Little Roger James there, prime of his life.
Yeah.
20-year-old, enjoying life, living life to the full. Ooh, who's this young lady? Go on.
Right.
I'm sort of setting it
well,
up.
Well, we've been friends for years, and then
who was she?
Huh?
Who was she?
She was a friend of mine, a girl called, I'm going to say her name, just in case she listens, because then I'd like her to get back in touch, actually.
But her name... Numbers game.
Yeah. You see?
Get as many as you can, as many interested as you can, and then you can set your picture. Go on.
But her name's Lucy.
Lucy.
Have
you made this name up?
No, okay. Her name's Lucy. It was definitely Lucy.
Lucy. What was her name? What's the second name?
I'm not saying the second name. Why? That'd be unfair, wouldn't it? No, actually, if I wanted to get in touch, I'd have to.
Totally.
Her real name was Lucy Kirby.
Lucy Kirby, lovely.
Yeah, and I absolutely adored this girl, and we've been friends for many years.
I think I read that she might have died.
Shut up, don't.
I think I read in a local paper.
Shut up.
Roger, I'm not even being cruel.
Shut up.
I think it was important.
I'm not going to tell you the story.
I think it was important for doing a gig.
Not going to tell you.
And I read in a local paper that she died.
I'm not going to tell you.
Of a broken heart.
Don't, because it makes me sad.
It does make you, you've got a proper sad face.
I do, it does make me sad.
This is great. The corpse has stirred for a moment, and I've just slammed my fist down on its face. Die!
You genuinely are horrible.
No, go on, let's hope that Lucy Kirby's alive and well.
But yeah,
and
I
not
was,
married.
I was about to go off and do a job, having just finished drama college.
Yeah.
And
telesales.
Lucy and I got back together, briefly. We were kind of having a big intense night, and it was coming out, and we were having that sort of big...
Sex.
No, hadn't at that stage actually. But anyway, this was months and months and months later, and we got back together, and we were kind of dating for a while. But I was going up to Glasgow to do this job,
right.
And I was getting really anxious about being away from her.
Okay.
And so one night we were at a pub, and it was kind of like my sort of leaving night, and so all my family were there, and it was a pub that my mate owned, and it was a really big night, and Lucy was there, and I was outside, and she was talking to me about the difficulties of a long-term relationship and all that, and I really wasn't liking where the conversation was going.
Yeah.
So I suddenly blurted out, but I've got a heart condition.
Okay.
And as soon as I'd said it, right...
Yeah?
My brain went... What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah, okay.
But I'd kind of bought myself into it, so I sort of...
Have you to this day ever told Lucy Kirby you didn't have a heart condition?
I haven't seen her since.
Jesus Christ. So she might think you're dead.
I know, yeah.
You told her... So wait, no, this is... What's
but this
even
is
worse
just
this,
desperate.
Though? You told her you had a heart condition, but you still never saw her again.
No.
I think you're hedging your bets thinking that Lucy Kirby will get in touch. Because if Lucy Kirby was happy enough to fucking get you out of her life, thinking you were terminally ill, then fucking there's no chance she's going to come back now, particularly given that you're now out of work and skinny.
It sort of backfired on me even bigger than that.
Because you had a heart attack.
No, because I kind of carried on a bit and in the same vein and got to the point where I was really quite tearful.
Did you have cancer? Did you have cancer
no,
as well?
No, but just still on the heart condition thing. But because
I've got AIDS and cancer
nurse,
and a heart condition.
I couldn't get specific about it, because she was asking me, well, what sort of heart condition? Well, that's, you know, like normal, proper, concerned questions. And obviously
say?
I couldn't answer any of them, so I just got more and more emotional.
Just cried a bit.
Yeah, and I cried.
And she
stuff.
Still left you?
No, and then her sister came out and sort of said, what's going on here? Lucy kind of relayed the situation to her, and I just remember Lucy sort of getting halfway through relaying it to Kath, and then she just stopped and went, do you know what, I can't handle this. And then she left.
And that was the last time you saw her?
And yeah, leaving me outside this pub, having done all this histrionics and stuff, then looking up and seeing my family in the window of the pub looking out, all going, what the fuck, you know, mouthing.
Is this your way of telling her and all your friends and all your family that you haven't got a heart condition? Do they all still believe this?
No, my family didn't hear the conversation. They were all inside the pub, but they'd obviously seen me outside getting emotional about something.
Yeah.
And that was it. And then I haven't been in touch with Lucy ever again.
I don't think you will.
So, yeah.
Have you tried Facebook?
I've looked her up on the internet and I've tried to sort of look on Friends Reunited.
She's probably changed her name by now. She's probably got a new identity the next morning.
I don't know.
She's probably the witness protection scheme.
Could be true.
I can't believe you would do such a thing.
That's really juvenile and stupid.
And you were 20 odd?
No, we're 20, yeah.
And you lied about
something really
being
stupid.
Ill.
I know. And the thing is, I don't even know what would have benefited.
Did you not learn from Den and Angie? I can't believe that a resident of Albert Square.
This is pre Den and Angie, isn't it?
It was
16 years ago, yeah.
Yeah, it wouldn't have been pretty
No, bad. Actually, no, it would have been peak Den and Angie time.
That's probably where you got the idea from.
Probably,
You probably watched EastEnders and watched Angie say that she was fucking dying to death. I went, I'm going to try that with
I'll
Lucy
try
Kirby.
That.
I'm going to give that a crack with Lucy Kirby.
Sorry, Lucy.
For the final time in this series, I feel I even saying that just sounds stupid. We're literally, we're having a couple of weeks off.
Yeah, but it's a season break.
You going on your holidays?
I don't know, actually. I might be.
I'm going to go abroad.
I might be going to Kuala Lumpur.
Okay, I'm not saying where I'm going.
Why?
I'm going to go to it because I don't want people to know. I'm going to go I'm going to fly somewhere.
Are you?
Take 2 weeks out.
Nice.
Yeah, but I'm not saying where I'm going.
Why?
Because I'll get stalked.
Well, who by?
The bad boys from around here.
Yeah,
the naughty boys.
They're really going to fly to Mallorca, aren't they?
The naughty boy. I'm not going to fucking Mallorca. the naughty boys will follow me, and that stalker woman from Australia who does all the websites. She'll probably try and check
out. Oh, yeah.
And loads of other people.
Loads.
I'm going to go away. I'm going to go away and clean out my closet.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You're coming out of the closet, did you say?
Yeah, I'm going to come out as gay, yeah.
Yeah.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. Actually, that reminds me.
Brings us nice onto benders.
Actually, well, because, listen now, right. No. Last week you had a go at me, or tried to have a go at me, about saying that I was excluding gay people.
No, never.
Right? Well,
I said you should have as many gay people as you want there.
Yeah.
And you were going, no, that's right. And I was going, well, why not?
Yeah, but right, anyway, right, because of the things you said, I thought about it, as always, I've reflected upon it.
Yeah.
Right? And last night,
Was this in the bath?
No. And I was, got to the car, but anyway.
You still got your car?
Yeah.
I thought you were on your ass.
Don't be ridiculous. Nothing's ever going to be that bad.
Don't you listen to yourself, sir. You've got one Cornish pasty in the fridge, but you've still got the car outside. Yeah, brilliant. Excellent work. Go on. When I was here last week, there was a black banana in
your
fridge.
Yeah, there was one black banana and, what, two tangerines or whatever they
called? Yeah, it looked like a cock and balls. No, but that was the most...
But that was left over from a full bucket, and that was all...
What's the matter?
That's only because I'd been away
There's
as
no
well.
There's no excuse to have a complete... That was a completely rotten banana.
But I've been away for a few days.
There wasn't even a little bit of yellow left on it.
It was black... No, actually, do you know what? They went black really quickly in that fridge. I think the fridge is too cold. But inside, it's not like black where it's gone...
I've never heard of a banana going off because it was too cold.
No, it hadn't gone off. Inside, it was fine. But the skin
Roger,
had gone black.
Please tell me
not
that
you
did
one.
Not eat that banana.
No, not that one, but prior to that,
I'll go and do you a shop.
I don't need you to.
I'll do you a shop, but you're getting healthy stuff. I'll be mum.
I've got loads of fucking stuff
I don't here. Like the idea of you eating, of it getting so bad that you eat a rotten banana.
I didn't eat it.
I've got an image of you sat in the bath, holding your nose so you don't have to taste it. And eating a rotten banana, because it's all the nutrient and sustenance you can get. He's eating a rotten banana, a Kit Kat, and a tin of peeled tomatoes.
Shut up.
For your dinner, for your Sunday dinner. That's what I imagine you've eaten.
Don't eat tomatoes.
I reckon you eat half a tin of sweet corn, then save the other half for the next day.
I'd have this week, because I made some chicken and sweet corn sandwiches yesterday.
Really lovely. Fantastic.
Really nice.
But you couldn't afford the chicken, so it was just sweet corn sandwiches. Yeah. And it wasn't actually bread, because you couldn't afford bread. But basically, you buttered your hand, sprinkled sweet corn over it, and then spent the day licking it off. Like, kidding yourself it was a veggie lolly. Covered in sweet corn, and you just wander around the park on your own with wasps on the string. Just licking the sweet corn off your hand. That's how I imagine you'll end up.
Fantastic.
4 weeks without me.
Thank you very much.
So anyway, we're going to talk about benders.
Right, so I was on the way to the club, and I was thinking about what you said, and I was thinking, well, we don't actually, not that I'd actually gone out of my way to look, but we don't seem to be getting many gay people coming to the club.
Yeah.
Which is surprising, considering the area that the club's in. So...
Gayland.
As it happens, I was
Gay in... Gay Street, Gayland.
Things were going on all right last night, and a couple of the guys came up from downstairs, from the dance floor, and they're saying, oh, have you seen those two lads at the back? And I was like, what are you talking about? And they're saying, oh, they're kissing and stuff. And I was like, oh, well, you know, great.
Kissing each other?
Yeah.
Two lads?
Yeah. So anyway, I was going down to speak to the DJs anyway.
Is it your club?
Yeah. So I went downstairs.
What did you do? Did you get security?
No, shut up.
No.
So I went downstairs and I was talking...
Joined in?
No, I was talking to the DJs. Are you going to let me tell this? You always tell me to keep stories tight and then you keep interrupting.
I just got a nice image of you being in the middle of a circle jerk.
Well, wait, because it gets more amusing.
I really hope this finishes with your face being decorated.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't.
Okay, go on.
I'll
drink your coffee, have a rest.
While I was there... Have
a quick drink of your coffee.
I don't want it now.
All right. Just holding it to keep warm.
Yeah.
Because you can't afford central heating.
Keep my hands warm, that's
can't
it.
Afford to put the central heating on.
No, yeah, in the height of summer.
Bless you.
So I was downstairs talking to the DJs, and two other people arrived... with the groups, there was now four and three. So there's three guys and one girl.
Yeah.
And the girl was very, very pretty. And
yeah,
they were all sitting together and all getting on fine. And as the club got busier, because it was a really busy night last night, they seemed to be having a really good time.
How many? 50 odd?
No, I think we had about 200 at one point, which I'm quite pleased with. So anyway, they were having a good time and dancing and all that. And quite a few times they'd come up to me sort of individually, and on one occasion the big tall guy and the girl came up and was saying, oh, is this your club and stuff? And I was like, no, I'm just promoting tonight and, you know, enjoying it. And they were like, oh, yeah, I love the music. And getting on really nice.
Is your club there?
It's not my club.
How about you wouldn't admit it to them? What, is that in case they came back? Is this your club? Oh, no, I'm not normally here. No, I don't want gays following me around.
No, I don't own the club.
Okay,
right. But anyway...
You don't own much, really, do you? Go on.
Your words were ringing in my ears, and I was thinking, you know what, this is great. And I was talking to this guy, and one of the guys runs a club on Leicester Square, Q Bar, which apparently is really popular. And so we're chatting away, getting on really well. One of the other guys works for BBC in production. And the girl is a dancer, and I didn't really get to find out what the other guy was doing. So we're chatting away, everything was great. There was another thing that happened, which I'll tell you about in a minute, which was a big fight. And then, which I'll tell you about that later.
Okay, great.
Because it didn't involve these four.
Yep.
And then by the end of the night, the three guys and the girl were saying that what a great time they'd had, and that, you know, they don't normally go to, in quotes, straight bars. And I was being so conscious of your words about me possibly being negative about gay people.
You sucked one of the cocks.
No. That it was chatting away, and it got to the stage where literally the bar was closed and everything. We're out on the street.
I get it. Get to the point of the fucking story.
And they were talking.
Jesus!
And they were talking.
Boring! Only goes too many words over and over again. Fucking listener, I know how you feel. I'm sat here in real life. At least when you listen to this, it will be edited down in some way. I've just sat and listened to this for what seems like 4 fucking hours. What you get on the podcast will probably be about 4 minutes. But I sympathise with you and empathise with you. Please keep listening. Hopefully something good will happen at the end of this story. If not, I can only apologise to you. You've listened to 10 fucking episodes, and this is a story you've been rewarded with.
Right, you're finished.
No! And another thing... Go on.
So anyway, I was being the host of the most, and I was being really nice, and chatting away, walking up the street,
You don't have to recap!
Well, I do.
People are just sat there thinking, just finish the story.
Well, if you
just
stop...
Just finish it.
If you stop interrupting, I will.
This is the equivalent of being in a social circle, and someone's telling a really, really long joke, and you're like, do you know what? I don't even care what the punchline is. I'm going to really, really laugh at this, on the off chance that it gets me away from this fucking person. So no matter what happens at the end of this story, we're all going to be happy. Well, look, do you know what? You could end this story with... And then I woke up and it was all a dream. And people would be sated by that. They'd actually feel okay about it. Whereas if it happened in a film of any weight, you'd go, that's a fucking cop-out ending. I'd be happy with that as an ending. I'd be happy with that.
But that isn't the ending.
All right, what's the ending?
The ending is that they were looking to get a night bus home. I said, where do you guys live? They said, oh, no, we live miles away. I said, whereabouts? They said, Croydon. I said, I'll tell you what, I'm going to be up for hours anyway. Jump in, I'll give you a lift. So they got in the car.
Yep.
I drove them all the way to Croydon, dropped them off. The whole time, there was a bit of uncomfortableness. I could kind of sense it, because they were like, what?
Because of your homophobia?
No, they were kind of sensing, why is he doing this? This is such a nice thing for someone to do. We're chatting, lovely chat, all the way home.
Right? Probably worrying you were going to charge him at that point.
Dropped them off, okay? Went up the street, U-turned, came back, and as I came back, they were still in their sort of doorway, and I heard, as I slowed down at the junction, I heard him say to her...
Well, he was a cunt, wasn't he?
No, I think he fancied you. And her say to him... Really? I thought he fancied you. And then I carried on going. And I thought to myself, you see?
That's genuinely friends. The end of the story, isn't it?
That is genuinely the end of the story.
That is genuinely what we've just sat through. We just sat through that story.
Yeah.
But...
But all of that was because I
can't believe that
you said.
I can't believe that when you were driving home last night, that after all that happened, you sat there going... I'm going to tell this story on the podcast tomorrow. That'd be a really good story.
But it was, to me, it was quite funny.
It was just, it was full, I mean, rammed full of superfluous information. That story could have been told in 30 seconds.
Go on then, you tell it.
It could be, right, all right, here's the story.
You tell it.
Oh, at Ben's last night, let me tell you this. There were these, a couple of gay guys were there, and I got a chat with them and stuff. And at the end of the night, because I was so self-conscious, thinking about what you said last week about Ben and about me not having gay people there, I thought, I'll offer him a lift. So I gave him a lift home, and when I dropped him off, I did a U-turn after I dropped him off, and I heard the girl that was with them saying to him, hey, I think he fancied you, and they went, I thought he fancied you. That's the end of the story.
Okay, you did.
That's literally it.
Yeah, you did it better.
I know!
Right, I get... Right, so I could have done that.
You've just wasted people's lives.
Okay.
What's the other story? What happened at the fight?
Big fight.
Brilliant. What a fantastic story.
Huge fight.
That's it. That's the end.
Okay.
What did anything happen in the fight?
Well, yeah, I sorted the fight.
What do you mean you sorted it?
There were seven guys, bouncers, right, from other clubs. Yep. Huge, big guys, right?
Really? Are you hated that much in Soho?
No.
But now the bouncers from other clubs are coming down to kick off in your
club. No, it's because it's a good club to go to. You see, people know it's a good club. But anyway, they were on a stag night. They came down. There was a bit of a scuffle downstairs.
Yep.
One of the sort of customers that wasn't in their group ended up running into the kitchen and hiding. Me and Dean, the main doorman, went down, eventually managed to get the guys to come up.
Yep.
Luckily, one of the guys recognised me from EastEnders. He'd worked with Steve McFadden, so I had a bit of pull. Right, there was no aggression.
Steve McFadden's been fighting this week.
Has he?
Yeah, he's been fighting.
Oh, well, this guy was...
They've had to rewrite his scenes in EastEnders. He got beat
up.
Oh,
no. So anyway...
No. That was great. You turned into fucking Les Dawson. Then you're like, oh, God, I'm surprised the council allow it. Oh, good. Don't. She's had the hysterical rectomy. Had it all taken away.
So anyway, it was all out on the street, right?
Just come back from Greece.
There was quite a few people worried.
Did you have the shish kebabs ever since we arrived?
Right. Little me steps up.
Did you go to the Acropolis? I was never off it.
Steps up into this crowd of big freaking testosterone-fueled guys, and then about half an hour later, we found out that those same guys had gone down to Barcelona, which is another club. One of them.
No, you can't tell any more of the story.
Yeah, no, just.
No, you ran out of time.
No, you can't do.
You ran out of time. No, you fannied about too much in that story, so we now never find out what happens in that story.
Oh.
That's the end of this section. I have nothing more to say.
Do you know what? I'm a bit spent.
I've nothing more to say. It's been horrific.
Why has it been horrific?
The last 10 weeks have been horrific.
Oh, shut up. You've enjoyed it.
On what level?
You laughed.
What art?
Me, mostly.
Yeah. You ridiculous man.
I know what this is.
How are you going to manage? What is it?
This is desperation, because you know we're not... Because we're not going to have an excuse to see each other for the next few weeks.
Well, I'll tell you what, though. In fairness, because I didn't go up to Edinburgh for the Fringe this year...
Yeah.
I thought, oh, well, that's all right, so I'll be doing the podcast.
Yeah.
And then we decided that we were going to pack... Oh, what am I going to do for the rest of the month, isn't it?
Well, we can still meet up.
That's what's going to cover me. You can't meet up. You've got your kids now.
Yeah, well, we can still meet up. We meet up.
Ruining it for everyone. Judas. Yeah. Well, we've had a laugh, haven't we?
I've had a great time.
On and off. And we had a good time with Ed as well. Ed will be back for the next series.
Yeah.
So we had some nice times with Ed. Well, there's been three of us here today.
There has been three of us, actually.
The person hasn't even bothered speaking.
We've had a silent partner.
Yeah.
Are you going to introduce...
Sucky over there, that's Sucky.
Hello, Sucky.
Just say hello. You can always say hello.
Hello.
Yay!
Hello, yeah. That's how I went to school, Sucky.
I know.
Yeah.
And that was senior school, right?
Yeah, Selwyn Jones High School. It's now called Newton Willows Community High School.
So that was...
Apparently it's got well rough.
Has it?
Yeah.
It wasn't when you were there?
Not really, I don't recall it being rough. Was it rough?
He's nodding. For the audience.
But then again, it wasn't rough for me, but it might have been rough for you. For Sucky, because he's a... What's the politically correct word for it?
Person of colour?
A brown boy. Okay, brilliant.
Right.
And a brown boy with a Scouse accent. How fucked is that? Can you imagine having to go to a school? This is in the 70s, this. So there we go. Well, it's been a laugh. And what was your best bit? Roggie, what was your best bit of the series? You've got to pick one bit. You can have one bit out of the entire series. What was your best one?
I like the Doctor Who questions.
Yeah, me too. Went on for quite a while, but it was funny.
But are you going to put... I really want to know, because there was one question that you did cut out, that I did an impressive feat, and you've cut it out. And are you going to put it in the best of?
No. It just went... The Doctor Who section, we recorded for almost an hour.
Yeah, I know.
And I got it down to, I think, 18 minutes on the podcast, which is still far too long for a section.
But it was
fucking funny.
There was some gold in there that wasn't in there.
Yeah, there was. Well, we asked you your favourite actors. And you listed them in the order you'd written them on the website.
Yeah, but you've got to explain that I didn't know. You had the questions and the answers in front of you.
Yeah.
And I couldn't remember what they were, and you asked me the questions.
But all it was, essentially, was 8 minutes of a memory feat.
But it was brilliant.
It's not really worth putting into a best of, is it?
Well, it was brilliant, though. Well, if you take it in its entirety.
It was brilliant to you, but it wouldn't be brilliant to...
You were impressed at the time.
We weren't really impressed. Again, we just wanted it to be over. like your story about Benders. It wasn't that we were impressed. We were just glad that you'd stopped listing them.
Right.
To be honest with you, the most I've ever laughed in my life, me and Ed both agreed on this.
Yeah.
And I mean, literally, in my life, ever, was during the Doctor Who questions.
Yeah.
I mean, it really was. We were hurting from laughing. And we did sit in my garden, me and Ed, going, I've never laughed that much in my life. And Ed was exactly the same.
Yeah.
That we'd never laughed that much in our lives. So thank yous. Anybody need to thank? Ed, let's thank Ed.
Well, if
in
you
his
must.
Absence. Oh, don't, you're horrible to Ed.
I'm not horrible to Ed. He's horrible to me.
Who can blame him?
Oh, stop it.
I'd like to thank Ed Gamble.
Have you heard from him?
No. Well, I had one text off him.
Okay.
But,
and?
He's busy, he's up in Edinburgh enjoying
himself. Do we know how it's going?
He seems to be quite happy, I think.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, actually, it reminds me, there's a whole section we haven't closed off.
What?
Your five hanging texts.
Would you listen to yourself?
Did anyone respond?
No. None of them.
Oh.
I had no text back from those five.
Not
texts.
One?
No. Do you know what?
Have you binned those five friends then?
Kind of. I'm kind
good
of,
on you.
I'm kind of past caring.
Good.
I do that, you know. Sometimes if someone upsets me, I fuck you.
Yeah.
I'll be stubborn, me.
Yeah.
So yeah, there we go. Yeah.
Don't cross him, people.
No, don't cross me, because I will.
Look how horrible he is to me, and I'm nice to him.
Yeah, you're my friend.
Yeah, joy.
So we need to thank Chortle.co.uk.
Thank you, Chortle.
Yeah, Chortle have been cool. People slagged Chortle off.
Who?
Me.
Right.
They gave me some rubbishy reviews.
Okay.
I'm meant to do that in one section, read a Chortle review and criticise it.
Right, okay, something to look forward to for season two.
Absolutely. But they've been sound with us and they've looked after us and they've hosted this brilliant, so thank you very much indeed to Chortle.
Okay. Can you hurry up now? I want to go to bed.
You're going for a little bed now?
I'm going to go to bed.
We're going to do another sleepy part.
Raji, do sleep now.
Raji, done sleep.
Yeah.
Well, we need to thank Raji, little Raji James. He used to be on Incenders but ruined it. Now, little Raji James. He used to be on a podcast, but ruined it.
Oh, cheers. Thank you. I was going to say thank you, but I'm not going to now.
You did ruin it, didn't you?
Well, thank you to the listener, but not thank you to you.
Fine, fuck you.
In fact, no, we should say thank you to you, because you've done all the editing and...
Because I'm the genius.
And it's very good.
I'm a genius behind this.
Cool.
I'm proud of this podcast.
Good.
Do you know why I'm proud of it?
Why?
Because it was an idea that I made happen.
Yes, that's a very good thing.
It wasn't. I didn't want to get to Christmas and still be saying to my manager, I'm going to do a podcast.
Yeah.
We did it.
We've done it.
We got it sorted out. The first four episodes are fucking terrible in quality, sound quality.
But we've learned. We've progressed.
Yeah, but you're still on it.
Well, I think
so
that's...
So how far have we progressed when you're still on it?
Well, hopefully, as usually happens in most jobs I do, I'll be replaced by season two.
Can you imagine? Do you know what? This is actually quite exciting. This could be the first time in your life...
I've gone to season two of something.
Well, you're recommissioned.
Hey.
Oh, don't, Raji.
That'd be exciting.
Do you know what?
You've just jinxed it.
Love you as I do, it's made me want to sack you. It's actually, you know what, it's just about me being stubborn. Yeah. I can see myself driving on going, no, I can't let him do it. I can't let him. If you're back for the next series, you win.
No, if I'm back for the next series, you win because everyone else sacked me, but you didn't.
I'm not going to fall for that.
No, don't.
What do you think I am? I'm not fucking seven.
Oh.
We'll see. You might be back, you might not. There you go. There's the cliffhanger we've been fucking searching for. Come back for the next series, it's going to be about a month's time, and Raji may or may not. Ed will be. Ed, my great mate, Ed Gamble, he'll definitely be on there. Ed Gamble, brilliant, love Ed. But right. Raji, little Raji James, he's been in Sense but ruined it, may not be back for the second series.
Oh.
I hope you are, but it's out of my hands.
You don't mean that now.
This has been the Ray Peacock Podcast, episode 10. Thank you very much for joining us. It's been a Big Enough production. I've been Ray Peacock. See you in a bit. Bye-bye. You've got girls from this.
Not from this.
You said to me, before we started doing this, yeah, it'd be really good, because I could play like, I can like act like I'm an idiot or something, but then girls will be attracted to that, and I'll get loads of pussy. That's what you said to me.
That does not at all sound like
that's
me.
Exactly what you said to me before we started
don't
doing
start.
This. And I was going, Raji, come on, you can't do it just for that. I said, don't call it pussy, that's horrible.
Do you know
and, what? And you went, I don't give a shit. I'm going, get me some pussy. And you said, like, I was like, Raji, what are you speaking like that for? You went, I don't care, I don't respect these biatches, is what you said. I just want to get me some pussy. And lo and behold, you did. It's fucking ridiculous.
Are you sure you weren't...
I ain't got no pussy from this goddamn podcast. All I've got is twatted around the corner from here.
Well, that's... Yeah.
Counts, annoying.
Counts. It's attention.
Yeah, it was... Well, I was physically close to someone.
Exactly.
Counts.
It's physical contact.
Yeah, it's not gay, though, is it? It's definitely not gay.